So in this video, I want to introduce you to something called Model Builder. And to do this, I'm going to right-click on Home, go to New, and say Toolbox. And then I'm going to call this Toolbox my Weekend 01. And a toolbox is just another fancy folder. Just like this guy was a fancy folder for storing raster layers, a toolbox is a fancy folder for storing models. So I'm going to go right click on this, go to New, Model. And then the first thing I'll do here is I'll go over to the Model Properties, go to Model, Model Properties, and then the model is fine. I'll just call it Model 01, and the label is, I'm going to say this is my distance problem. If I say OK, that changes the title here. It doesn't change anything there, but if I hit Save, now that's just being called distance problem. And so what I'd like to do is create a workflow in this thing. Just like we were making workflows, I was making workflows on the blackboard, but now I want to do it on this kind of whiteboard here. And basically Arc is going to save everything that we do here as, I think it's a Python script. So basically this is a way to program without having to learn a verbal syntax. Instead, it's just, we just have to learn a visual syntax that I think is a lot easier as an introduction. So I'm going to throw, the freshman dorm onto my white canvas. And notice that it's a circle, just like I was kind of using circles on the blackboard. And then I'm going to go to search, and I'm going to pick reclassify, right? Because what we need to do is first reclassify this so that there we get rid of the no data. That we get rid of the zeros and make the zeros no data. So did you see what I just did there? I had typed in reclassify, but you guys can do that. I grabbed the reclassify from spatial analyst, not from 3D analyst, because I've already asked for permission to use this, and I think I just talked about this, right? So anyway, I grabbed it from this, and then, you know, because I never really want to pass up the opportunity to wave a magic wand around if one's presented to me, so I clicked on this guy to get a magic wand. And then I'm going to click on this and drag it over to here and then release and say that that's my input raster. And that's about as far as I can get with a magic wand. That's kind of where the magic stops. And it was a pretty, not a very exciting card trick, but that was about all I could do there. And so now what I want to do is make sure that my zeros go to no data. These I can just leave out, or if, you know, or I can make that one. And right, so last time I just let it out, but this should give us the same result, because now I'm saying anything that is a little bit greater than zero or one is going to be one, and then everything else is going to be no data. And then my output is going to be something that I'm going to call my O2B, since we're making it from the model builder, and it's going to be, what is this? Frosh dorm no, or background zeros, zerps. Are you cool with that, or should I make it zeros? I kind of prefer zerps, but I realize that could be kind of confusing, so then I'm going to say okay. And then I'm going to save the model, and then before I go any further, I'm actually going to go further. I'm going to go to search and pick up Euclidean distance. And I'm going to drag and drop that guy onto here. And notice how it's just bringing the tool on. So again, I have this magic wand, so I can drag, click on this, drag it over here and release, and say this is my input raster. And now, if I go in here, I can say, okay, 02 Frosh Dorm, cool. My output distance is going to be this, and actually it's going to be in here. I'm going to call it my O3B distance from dorm. And my output cell size is set for 1. I can say okay. And I think we're good. And now what I can do is save this, and then go to model, and say run the entire model. Now don't get alarmed that that flash is like, that's just, it's working so hard that all the blood comes to its face type of thing. It's not a reason for alarm. But anyway, it ran through it. It gives you this report of what it did, that it first, you know, it did reclassify and then it did this, and it tells you how long each process took. And you say, thanks very much. And I'm again going to just save that because I hit save a lot. And lo and behold, if we go here, we should see that there are these new outputs. They didn't get automatically added to our map. But if we take O2B and throw it on, what you'll see is that we once again created what we were after. And if we take this and throw it on, we get this kind of kind of rainy and Middlebury kind of a thing. But if we went and changed it to a little kind of electric ladyland here, what do we get? Yeah, that's pretty similar to what we got before, correct? I think they should be pretty much identical. I think the difference here is that I'm using a different palette, right? So anyway, should I take the time to find the right palette? I'm kind of, there's so many damn palettes. Was it this one? Excuse me, so many darn palettes. Yeah, so identical, right? We got the same results. Okay, so that's a handy way of saving the process and not just the outputs, okay? And that's one of the benefits of Model Builder. See you later. Cheers.